Peyton, you're misunderstanding me. I said you're neurodivergent.
You're a nerdvergent!
Yes, hello. Was anybody else curious as a child about how we are supposed to spell letters? If one can spell a number, surely one must be able to also spell similar characters. Like the letter A exists, how do you spell it? Because if I'm saying it, that means it's a word. How do I spell that word? H is another excellent example of a letter that should be spelled. Couldn't it be spelled A-Y-C-H or A-I-C-H? I was told explicitly I was incorrect. I let this one go pretty quick, but I never forgot. Similarly, with the concept of time, you must actually suspend logic in order for clocks to make sense. And that's fine, we've agreed as a collective that that's what we're gonna do. I just think it's important that none of us ever forget that to make the world work, the rules that we all decided to follow stop somewhere. Because someone arbitrarily drew a line that said anything after this is too complicated. Some people have accused me of being too granular, including the many doctors who diagnosed me with two learning disorders. I maintain that I am a truth seeker. Carry on.
Pode me dar sequência de peixe, mas quero que aguente meu sentadão.
I give to you my husband. He refuses to believe that he is neurodiverse. Come, babe, what spoon are you using?
Dyslexic trait that has nothing to do with reading or writing. Did you know that it's very common for dyslexics to really struggle with their lefts and rights? Often it can feel like you know which way is left and right, but it just takes you a couple of seconds to work it out.
Welcome to the Divergent Minds Club.
If you haven't heard of us yet, we are a queer, disabled, neurodiverse,
and of course, mentally ill,
small business that makes very discreet STEM and chewy jewelry. Everything we make is in some way interactive. And of course, it's all disability friendly. We have worry stones you can rub and play with on their chains. And our theirs and theirs non-binary bear earrings. While it looks like regular jewelry, we actually have chewy beads you can chew on. We have fuzzy keychains with a bunch of fun sensory charms. Our trans STEM bears, our lesbian STEM bears, and so many more. And soon we'll have custom bears for every flag. We have bracelets and clip-on earrings, and as soon as I get my hands on a drill and some wire, we will have custom wire-wrap fidget rings. At the end of every month, 10% of our earnings is donated to the Legacy of Hope Foundation. I hope you'll follow along for the ride, because this is just the beginning.
I can borrow.
Yeah, there's one underneath the seat by the seat adjusting thingy. Why do you know that it's underneath your seat by the adjusty thingy?
Because that's where I saw it.
So why wouldn't you just pick it up and like put it on your shift knob or something?
Because I've already imprinted the memory in my head that it's on the floor by the shift knob thing. If I pick it up and move it, I'm going to forget that I moved it, and then I'm only going to remember where I saw it last, and I'm not going to remember where I moved it to. Duh.
Oh, that's right. You've got that ADHD thing. Got it. Do you have any, never mind. I'm not even going to ask.
Hey, could you put $20 on pump 2 for me? Neurodiversity affirming? What's that mean?
Oh yeah, I'm a pediatric therapist. This just means that the kids that I work with, they have brain differences like ADHD, autism, dyslexia, and in our therapy, we view those as different brain types rather than disorders.
Right on, I like that. I had some brain differences, you know what I mean? I know what you mean, and I hope that you felt affirmed throughout your life. I appreciate that.
Choose your character!
I'll blow up into smithereens and spew my tiny symphony all up and down a city street while trying to put my mind at ease, like finishing this melody. This feels like a necessity, so this could be the death of me, or maybe just a better me. Now come in with the timpanis and take a shot of Hennessy. I know I'm not there mentally, but you could be the remedy, so let me play my violin for you.
How was your day?
It was great. Just calming down from the stimulation.
What do you mean, what happened?
Oh, nothing. I just get overstimulated and then it's like hard to talk maybe, so...
You kind of drifted off there at the end.
I get overstimulated and then it's hard to talk and be social.
Like, I'm running out of words.
Huh?
Running out of words. I'm sorry, my tone. I'm not angry. It's just a lot to like talk right now.
Okay, just let me know if you need anything.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, did you hear me? I was just let me know if you need anything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Man, my foot is killing me. Oh, yeah, last year I pulled a muscle in my foot. It sucked. Okay, I've been noticing this for a while, but why do you relay everything that I say back to yourself? It comes across as really self-centered. Shoot, I'm sorry. I know it may seem that way, but in reality, it's actually my way of trying to show you that I'm engaged in the conversation and I care about what you're saying. Oh, really? For some reason, the best way for me to process new information is to tether it to something that I've already experienced. Oh, so by relating what I'm saying to your experiences, you're trying to communicate that you understand what I'm feeling and you empathize with it. Yes, exactly. That. Got it. So you're not trying to actually draw the focus of the conversation to what you're saying, you're just being a really active listener. I think that's a pretty good way to put it.
You know what pisses me off literally so much? When neurotypical people complain about how autistic people are poor with communication and have poor social skills, when in reality, they are the ones who have poor communication and poor social skills. Neurotypical people love to say phrases like read the room or read in between the lines, or my personal least favorite, when they're like, oh, like, their silence is telling you everything you need to know. Their silence speaks volumes. No, actually their silence does not speak volumes, because the volume is at zero, because they're literally not saying anything. If you really wanted me to understand how you feel, then maybe you would use direct communication with direct language and articulate exactly what you're trying to say without all these weird innuendos and beating around the bush.
Sir, will you please stop staring at me?
Where's the rest of you?
If you ain't got no money, take your broke ass home, you say.
If you ain't got no money.